Some thoughts about video promotion on YouTube that I have discovered yesterday. So I released a new video called How to Promote Your Video on Facebook, which is generally a hands-on session about promoting yourself in Facebook groups, filtering them out, deciding which ones are relevant, and how to keep that a track of all your groups in general. But the interesting thing that I found, I actually estimated where should my video be placed in search results and how hard the competition is based on the vidIQ insight. So for example, if you look for how to promote your video on Facebook, come on, you'll see that my video, a new one, immediately ranked approximately so it's ranked the fifth or sixth place immediately, only after a few hours. And when we look at the results from vidIQ, which is a Chrome plugin that you can install in order to get some insights about the videos, you see that the competition is 12. And the interesting part is very, very important. Times in title and times in descriptions. Right now it's 1 out of 20 and 1 out of 20 for both. And both belong to me. And then you see videos added in the last 7 days. So I'm trying to figure out the criteria to which I would adhere my YouTube ranking video, right? Videos that I want to place and have them rank well in search. And so far, it seems that it is working really well. What I see is the following. When you have this report by vidIQ here, this shows here, you see that added the last 7 days, it would be in most situations for long tail keywords, it would be 0 out of 20. Now, YouTube from time to time takes your new video and posts it directly into various search results that are related to your video just to test it out how it works there. Right, and when you see that there are 0 out of 20, there is a good chance that your video would appear in those results at least for 1 or 2 weeks, which is really great. If you have, if you want to test your new video, this is a great opportunity. If you see 5, 7, 6 new videos in the category, maybe it's not a good idea to name your video according to what you have found on this specific search result. But when you see there are 0 out of 20, there is a very good chance that your video would be featured there. Another thing is time in title and time in description. People are not bothering to input the keywords, to insert the keywords in title and in description simultaneously. And for specific search results, this is very crucial. Because, well, think about that. When you need to run a query for specific search results, what do you do? First of all, go to the table and see what is matching from text perspective, right? And this is the simplest thing you can do. Match your keywords in title and description. Facebook is Facebook. YouTube is not Google. It wouldn't hurt you if you would stuff your keywords at least a little bit in the same way, right? So title and description matching a little bit, to them it's not a problem. Their main concern is how much people are actually, how much time they are watching from in your entire video. Just to remind you, 10-minute video watched for 10 minutes by every user is a perfect score, for example, right? 100% views. If their audience retention is somehow like 10%, 30%, your video is relevant and it would go down in search results almost immediately. So going back to YouTube, if you have the same keywords in your title and description, they would not punish you because to them, it's only an initial rating factor, but in the longer term, they just don't care. All right. So this is what I found. Another interesting thing is tags. So I use Longtail Pro to stuff my tags in the video description itself. So as you see right here, when we look at the video, we see that, of course, you need to separate the words, the most important part ones in the beginning, and then you start stuffing your keywords, your tags, with various long tail keywords. And in order to understand that, you need to know what people are searching over the internet, and Longtail Pro, or you can use AdWords, doesn't matter really. You just put your video title and see what other results are related to you, and just copy and paste them here. Important notice: apparently, if you have a 5 or 6 long, 6 words long titles or tags, YouTube does not take it kindly and asks you to remove those tags. So don't spam, just be relevant. The idea is having some kind of an insight of what people are searching. Tags are not that important, really, and you will see that many, many popular videos have basically 1 or 2 or 3 tags general, and that's it. And some people are just stuffing them endlessly, and still they rank the same, so it's not that important. The important part about tags is when you have suggested video on the right, that to determine what videos are related to the specific video that you are watching right now, the tags are coming pretty handy there. Maybe they're not the main factor, but they are most certainly contributing. And so this is what I've done. Another important part about keywords: don't try to invent new keywords, right? Use the ones that already exist. So, for example, if you have go to how to promote your sorry about the those ones that I already put them on my own, your video, as you see, there are two search results here. So if you change it to something that doesn't appear here, you are creating an entirely new keyword that nobody was looking for. I tested the help page for the autocomplete function, and they state that it is using mostly search results as a suggestion here. Sometimes they try to figure out what you're searching for and would insert a word even if nobody searched for the specific term. So the main idea here is popularity. So we have only 2 results here, not that great. If you go back a little bit, you see there are approximately 10 results. So the one of the on top would be the most popular one. Let's try, for example, let's do something that we haven't done before. How to write a great, something like that. And you see, this is the most searched result, and it goes down up until something is not really searched. But use the one of those and just check. For example, we look for this one, just a keyword that we chose in random, right? And we see that in this situation, people put time descriptions and time and title pretty tightly to this specific keyword, and there is a one new last video. So, for example, searching putting your new video in this category might be a little bit harder. If we would look at the competition, it's about approximately 23. So it means that it is pretty easy, but it's harder, for example, from my example that I posted about the Facebook promotions. Now, I'm not expecting to get too many search results at this point. And I still need to promote my videos on Facebook and maybe Google Plus a little bit. And now I'm actually going to create a session about how do you do that, because I have a new video and now I can create a session how I promote it in Google Plus, which actually brings more results than Facebook. You can post to 10 or 15 groups in Facebook and only 2 or 3 times in Google Plus, and Google Plus would just overrun Facebook, like just like that. The reason behind that is, of course, the nature of Google Plus users. They just tend to share more, being more engaged. If they're already there, they're doing something, right? You can be passive on Facebook, but Google Plus does not allow you to be passive and still enjoy it. So people are mostly very active. So this is the outtakes that I have so far about my channel promotion. I don't have too much growth reports to share right now because, well, there is not too much to grow about. I'm still trying to get to 10 videos count in order to breach the first milestone. And then we will see how it goes from there. I have 13 videos, but most of them are private because I discontinued some of them, my previous videos, which is really, 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 really interesting. But for some reason, for example, for how to promote your videos on Facebook got 4 views in 10 hours. And this, just to remind you, this channel is not promoted in any weird way, right? Or any common way. I don't share it with my family or my friends or anybody. So all of those views are genuine. and it's already outranking most of other videos that just did not get the same attention or the same methodology applied to them. And it's really weird, not really weird, but really exciting for me. So hope this will bring me some more results in the future. We're not going into mass production yet, into mass promotion yet, because well, there are milestones to reach, right? But we're still getting there a little bit slowly, and hopefully next time it will be something else. In the next week or so, I will release a YouTube experiment, which would be a really interesting way to see how YouTube reacts to experiments in general. And hopefully you will enjoy it as well. You can subscribe to my channel if you want to see them, you know, or just like my video, but that doesn't matter. By the way, I don't really care for likes or dislikes because they don't contribute anything to the rankings of anybody's videos. So just a thought for your videos as well. Don't get excited when you get liked or disliked. It's not a ranking factor at all. So hope you enjoyed this vlog. I certainly did. See you soon.